breakfast. And now you can see there are people from nearly all the world, but there are some from India and Asia, and they are playing volleyball. And now you can see all the teams.
Okay, good morning, June the 30th, here in Tabriz in Iran. Today we're off to Tehran, going to move 700 kilometers in one day, something like that. It's the equivalent of 2 weeks biking, so I'm not so happy about that, but Mette thinks it's a good idea, so that's all right. So that'll be good. I'm going to meet up with Per and Kirsten and Mette's mum and dad tonight. So yeah, that's what we're doing today. So this place was good. Actually, the first hotel we've been in where everything seems to work. Even the taps are connected correctly. In all the hotels for the last few weeks, there seem to be the hot and cold water taps just seem to be consequently always fitted incorrectly. But and the shower always leaks. But yeah, nothing leaks. Everything works. So good place.
I have never tried to be in a Iran hotel, but it's actually very beautiful. I think it's very European, because I think it's very beautiful. The same some in Europe, you can have a hotel very beautiful and fancy lights.
Jamie's impressed because the under 18 volleyball championship is on the way, world championship, so all the teams from India and Kazakhstan are all sitting having breakfast with him.
Yeah,
so, thought that was cool, even though we know nothing about volleyball. We don't even know who these people are, but Jamie liked that. Okay, we are packing away now, and let's get in the minibus.
Yeah.
We'll have a day sitting down, just sitting there watching the world go by on the way to Tehran. See you later. This
Bye-bye.
Is interesting. Something everybody needs to know. Here we're in Iran, filling up with fuel. What do you think fuel costs here? I'll tell you now. 8 liters costs €1. Yes, can you believe it? 8 liters for €1. Wow, in Denmark, 1 litre costs €1.6.
See that Peugeot there? He's filling the whole tank of that.
That's going to cost him,
what do you say, €7?
€7 to fill the whole tank. They're rolling on the Iranian motorway here. Be nice and easy going, by the looks of it.
Yeah, it's good.
Nice there, with the window open, keeping cool. Oh, this is an Iranian service station. The toilet facilities there, a lot like in Turkey. Standing toilets here. In public places, and then normal European style in hotels.
It is quite dry, but also it's nearly the 1st of July. A month ago it would have been a bit greener. Some places are very dry and brown, mountains are brown. But then we come through other places where it's a bit more green, and there's, right here we are now, there's fields where they grow wheat. And we also see places with trees. A couple of hours ago we were driving through an area that was much greener also, the mountains was a bit greener. So it changes a bit. But different to what I had imagined. It is actually a bit greener than I thought. It's not just a desert like I thought.
Just stop for a lunch break. And then this is the Sultanai Dome, built by a Mongolian king in the 14th century and believed to be his mausoleum. The biggest brick built dome in Iran and third biggest in the world.
This is made in a Baroque style, so it's believed that this has influenced some of the buildings and churches in Florence as well.
So we've been driving along Sahid. Our guide has been telling us a little bit about Iran, some introduction to it, and telling us that one of the main forms of income in Iran is of course oil. He was telling us that not always a good thing, oil, for Iran, because that means that the government of Iran, they focus that much on revenue from oil that they forget all other industries. And he's tried to boost tourism in Iran, but the government just aren't interested. They earn enough money from oil, so the everything else is neglected. And, also a lot of engineers, they are highly educated in Iran, but then they go to other countries, and the biggest export of Iran after oil is engineers, but they go to other countries to work as well. So a few interesting things we've learned this morning. And they have agriculture. They produce a lot of nuts and other fruits that they produce in this area.
We're going to get closer to Tehran now, they're about 100 kilometers away.
Come on my home.
Yes, you're back home now.
Yeah.
A city of over 10 million people. This will be the biggest city we've been to so far on the trip. Tomorrow we're going to visit that tower there, you can see. The good thing in Iran, the signs are in Farsi and in English. That helps. Guess who's back? Third Danish family. Say hello to Mette's mum and dad, and Per and Kirsten are back again. We'll be together for 10 days again.
Yeah, it was not easy, but now we're here.
Yep. Succeeded in the end,
yes,
after a lot of hard work. So
yes.
Yeah, we'll be together for a week, sightseeing and seeing Iran together.
Yes, we do forward for that. Yeah.
And Lena and Kirsten are looking very good in their headscarves. Oh wow, that's all the flags where Jamie's been. Oh, Jamie's got some presents from Per and Kirsten to put on his bike. People can see where he's from. And stickers to give his friends he meets on the road.
Yeah, and this to my back on the back.
Yeah? Perfect. Everybody always asks us, where are you from? Where are you from? Nobody has no idea, but now they can show them we're from Denmark.
So we made it to Tehran. We're in the inside our hotel here. So we're going to be staying for two nights. Tomorrow we'll be here and do some sightseeing around Tehran with our guide. So a very informative guy. So I'm sure we'll be giving a lot of information tomorrow about Tehran. So a huge city though. It's the biggest place we've been so far. So it'll be interesting to see. So then we'll be here tomorrow, and then the day after we'll be in a new minibus that moved our bikes into a bigger minibus, so a space for all of us, and then we'll be off going to a place called Kashan. So we've heard that's a really nice place, so we look forward to that. So So tomorrow is Tehran, so I'll see you in the morning.